Hey, a week two win for Tampa Bay. We did it all in Carolina's house, 20-14. It was not the best game, but you know me, we got Bucko Bruce. I'm happy for Bruce Arians' first win and our first win for the season and ending that 12-game losing streak for Jameis Winston. So a lot of good in this game, a little bit of bad. It wasn't the best, it was kind of sloppy, but hey, a win is a win. Great momentum shifter. Get the season out right, 1-1, it's okay. It's still early in the season. But before I get into my reaction, if you are new here, make sure you click the subscribe button down below as I will be posting weekly Buccaneer reaction videos. So make sure you do that and let's get started. I'm going to start with the losers of the game. I only have one. I didn't want to be too harsh on them, but the first one is overall coaching. Not that they're making bad decisions, but the team is not disciplined. We're getting too many penalties, pre-snap penalties, especially on the offensive line. DeMar Dotson had a few, and honestly, I think it's time that DeMar Dotson may need to go. He's getting older. He's not looking the same. He's not able to block as well. We need to figure out something. Is he going to get benched in the middle of the season? Maybe. I don't know who we have that could replace him, but I think coaching needs to do better in disciplining the team to make sure we don't get pre-snap penalties. Penalties during the play, that's fine. Sometimes they're accidental, but the pre-snap, we can't keep having false starts. I think we had a lot of false starts this game. There was a couple. There was one drive where we had a bunch. So I think that not too big of a deal because it didn't really impact the game, but something we got to work on. But enough of all the negativity. Let's get into the positives of the game. So the number one winner of the game, probably the most important, is our defense. I think our defense is legit. Now, put a disclaimer there. I know San Francisco was not the best of offenses and Carolina has had its struggles, but Carolina put up 27 points at home against the Los Angeles Rams. So the fact that we were able to hold them to 14 at home, and one of it was a safety. They only scored on offense 12 points. So four field goals. They didn't even get in the end zone. So that's a major win. Shaq Barrett, AKA Sack Barrett, 3 sacks. I think he leads the league now in sacks. Great pickup. I know in Denver he was like third string or something. He didn't play much. But now that he has opportunity to start, he is balling out. We held Cam Newton to 0 touchdowns. And we had that one interception that was called back, but it's okay. He threw under 50%, horrible statistic from him. Now, he did overthrow a lot of players and things like that, but there was a lot of throws that he had on target that our defense was just all over. We held Christian McCaffrey to like no yards. I think outside of their last drive where they were obviously playing, you know, no huddle and trying to get yards, McCaffrey had like 30 yards on like 16 carries and like one catch for 6 or 7 yards. So compared to what he did last week with like 200 yards of total offense, we completely shut him down. And let's give a special shout out to Vernon Hargreaves. A lot of people calling him a bust because he didn't play up to expectations. However, he had that pick six last week and then the biggest play of the game today where he held Christian McCaffrey from converting that fourth and inches. And he held him and saved the game for us. So Vernon Hargreaves has definitely stepped up. He did say that he felt a lot more comfortable under Todd Bowles. So the fact that we have an aggressive coach that can work to his strengths is amazing. So overall, giant shout out to the defense. If our defense can continue to play this way and our offense can average maybe 24 points a game, I see us finishing the season with a winning record. Next big winner, Jameis Winston. He definitely needed a rebounding game. It wasn't his best game, but there were no serious mistakes. There was two plays that were almost picks that were kind of bad, but overall, he held his composure. He started the first quarter not so well, but then he picked it up. He had about 16 completions for over 200 yards and a touchdown. He should have had a second touchdown, but Rashard Perriman, you lay out it, you had to have caught that. I know that's one thing that doesn't show up on the stat sheet, because if he catches it, we go up by 2 scores and it's a totally different game and Jameis gets more praise. But the fact that Perriman dropped it or didn't even really touch it, I mean, it's gonna go against Winston. That he didn't have the greatest game, but listen, after that game he had last week that was super atrocious, we needed something like this. So I'm very glad that he is playing well. Typically when he has really, really bad multi-interception games, he usually turns around and plays a really good game after. I think he ended up with over 100 QB ratings. So definitely very, very big. He's not like, it wasn't the greatest performance, but compared to last week, we definitely needed to see that. Now, the third winner of the game is the offense as a whole. Chris Godwin, 121 yards, a touchdown. He definitely carried the slack. Evans played okay, not typical Evans. He hasn't really been himself this season, but I think he will get back into form. I'm not too worried about it. But now we actually have a receiver that tries hard on the opposite side. Last year, DeSean Jackson, he didn't care. He wasn't trying. He was giving up on routes. But Godwin, that man's the real deal. He really balling out there. So the fact that we have him, great performance. We had 100 yards rushing. We just touched 100 yards, and Peyton Barber had like 80 something of it. So I wanted Ronald Jones in there. He didn't really do too much. Maybe against this specific team with their hard hitting linebackers and their good D-line, we needed a stronger back up front. He may not be the fastest, but he can get little chunks at a time. And he did break a couple, that touchdown he had. So I think he played really well, but the fact that we were able to hit 100 yards rushing as well, amazing. The fact that we were able to win this game with only like 280 total yards of offense, which is very low, just speaks about how good the defense has been. Overall, a very, very solid performance. I'm really proud of the team having that horrible performance last week, choking the game away with that Jameis Winston interception, pick six, turning around in 4 days' notice, not really having practices, just walkthroughs, going into Carolina, withstanding that rain delay in the middle of the first quarter, and then coming out and playing dominant defense, having that stand at the end, the goal line stand, to help us seal the game. So very, very proud of the team. Great turnaround. I still don't think the team is playing up to their potential. I think the defense is up there. Obviously, there's some miscommunication sometimes and some bad coverage, and some receivers get open. But again, when you have a new defense, these mistakes do tend to happen somewhat regularly. So by midseason, the defense will be probably top 10 for sure. I could see it going into top 5, especially if our D-line performs like they did today. Now our offense, again, I think we'll go into the top 10, but they're still learning. There was a quote from Bruce Arians years ago with Carolina, or with Arizona, where he said about Palmer, when Palmer had that really bad first season, he said, when you have veteran quarterbacks who are stuck with one system through their career, it takes a few weeks for them to unlearn those things and learn the new one. So I'm not really worried about it. I think Jameis will continue to play better. But luckily for us, our next game is at home against the New York Giants. We've seen them really, really wet the bed against the Dallas Cowboys. So if they continue to play that bad, that's a very, very good game at home. And I can see us actually going 2-1 after next week. So I'm glad we get to go home. We get a long 10 days off, 9 days off, something like that. We have a long, long week. So it's similar to like a bye, like a fake bye. And then we prepare for the Giants. That's more than enough time for Bruce Arians and his staff to put together a great, great game plan. So yeah, before I go, I want you down below to comment. What do you think about our defense? Do they look legit? Do you think they're going to be good throughout the rest of the season? Please let me know. I really want to know what people's opinions are. Throughout the last few days, it's all been about Jameis, but I want to see how we're doing on the other side of the ball. So let me know. And make sure you click subscribe down below. I will be posting weekly videos, like I said, on the Bucks, reactions to every single game. But I have to keep it short because it's getting really late at night, and I don't want to do a long one. Y'all don't want to watch a long one. So thank you for tuning in. Let's go Bucks, 1-1, second place in the division. Let's hope all our other division rivals lose, and let's get ready for the Giants so we can dominate and go 2-1 to start the season. Let's go Tampa Bay. Our offense tough, our defense rough. Go Bucks, go Bucks. Ain't no other team stopping us. Go Bucks, go Bucks.